Hello everyone, myself Dr. Maddineni, Srinivas. I teach dermatology in my YouTube channel. So this is today's MCQ. A defect in the gene ATP2C1 is associated with which of the following conditions? And this we can see is just a memory based MCQ, and if you have remembered it as Hailey Hailey disease, you are absolutely correct. And so we will see each of these options little bit. Okay, just a brief brush up of your concepts. So Hailey Hailey disease and Dariers disease, I hope all of you do remember, these are vesiculobullous disorders, and these both of these are inherited acantholytic disorders. So both of these are inherited acantholytic disorders. And the basic defect here is going to be with the calcium transportation. Okay, calcium transportation will be defective, because of which there is going to be primary acantholysis. So both of these are again examples of primary acantholysis. I hope you all know the concept of primary and secondary acantholysis. So Hailey Hailey disease is autosomal dominantly inherited condition due to the defect in the ATP2C1. Whereas Dariers disease, it is again autosomal dominantly inherited condition, but here the defect is ATP2A2. Okay, just remember this. And the rest of the options, Pemphigus vulgaris, it is a vesiculobullous disorder, whereas it comes under category of autoimmune blistering disorders. Autoimmune blistering disorder. So that is one point which you must remember. And this comes under intraepidermal blistering disorder. So it is an intraepidermal blistering disorder. And what is the target antigen? Because it is autoimmune, so there has to be some target, and the target antigen in Pemphigus vulgaris is desmoglein 3, more common than desmoglein 1. Okay, so this is a component of desmosomes, which do help in connecting the keratinocytes with one another. And coming to the fourth option, pemphigoid gestationalis, this is also called as bullous pemphigoid, which is seen in pregnancy, or it is also called as herpes gestationalis. Herpes gestations. And here there is going to be BPAG2 related antibodies. So antibodies will target BPAG2 in the case of pemphigoid gestationalis. So I am very happy that many of the students have marked Hailey Hailey disease as the answer here. You can see the student from YouTube has also answered. So as I have already told you, Hailey Hailey disease, autosomal dominant, this is the defect, ATPase, calcium transporting 2C member 1. So that is the reason why 2C1. Okay, so this will make calcium concentration in the cytoplasm, but because this is defective, there is going to be acantholysis, because calcium is required for the proper metabolism inside the keratinocytes. If it is defective, there is going to be loss of cohesion between the keratinocytes. And I hope you all remember, in histopathology we can see dilapidated brick wall appearance in the case of Hailey Hailey disease. So until this, everything is rote memory. But here comes one interesting thing. If you remember, in the vesiculobullous disorders, in the genetically acquired disorders, in the genetically acquired disorders category, I hope you all have remembered this very important group of conditions, which are mechanobullous disorders. I hope you all remember mechanobullous disorders, under which you might have read epidermolysis bullosa, simplex epidermolysis bullosa junctional, and epidermolysis bullosa dystrophica. And if you remember these entities, all of these are genetic, just like Hailey Hailey disease, but the manifestation in these conditions usually is from the birth. Whereas if you observe very carefully, Hailey Hailey disease has this unique feature in the clinical features, that is, there is going to be manifestation in the second or third decade, not at the time of the birth. So this is what is the point which I want all of you to focus on. This is very, very important. So what will be the clinical features? It is not very important, but the clinical feature, that is the manifestations, will be seen only after second or third decade, but not since birth, despite this being a genetically acquired condition. This is what I want to emphasize in this entire video. This is what is conceptual apart from the rote memory of the genes and all stuff. And one more thing, what will be the clinical features? It is going to be usually in the intertriginous area, that is in the axilla and the neck and in the groin. These patients are going to have intertrigo or tinea cruris like features. Okay, that is, there will be vesicles, there can be bulle, there can be maceration, there can be smell, that is, there can be foul smelling, discharge can also be seen. So basically the features sometimes will be confused with that of candida, that is candidal intertrigo in Hailey Hailey disease, and it needs a proper examination and also biopsy to finally diagnose this as a case of Hailey Hailey disease. And of course, Dariers disease, it is associated with ATP2A2 defect. And also you must remember that these are associated with chromosomes. Hailey Hailey disease with chromosome number 3 and Dariers disease with chromosome number 12. So this is just that thing. And this Dr. Maddineni Srinivas signing off. Happy learning dermatology. Sarvam Sri Krishna Arpanam. Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu.